these are typically overpopulated and communities with high poverty rates, and unfortunately they have become ideal places for the spread of the coronavirus, not only because they're overpopulated and they're poor, but also because they lack access to basic services. So for instance, the most basic directive in fighting the coronavirus, which is wash your hands regularly with clean water and soap, can be a difficult thing for slum residents to do on a daily basis. But also, social isolation policies have a dramatic impact on the lives of slum residents, most of whom are in the informal labor market. So they face an impossible choice between staying home, staying healthy, on the one hand, and losing their job and not being able to pay for food or for rent on the other. And some of the social isolation policies have made this actually worse. So for instance, poor families relied on the public school system to feed their kids at least once a day. Now these kids are at home, and these families need more resources and not less, more resources to be able to feed them. Civil society groups in the slums are playing at least two really key roles. One is to raise awareness about the crisis and fighting misinformation campaigns. And the second is being a bridge between people who want to donate resources, money, food, and people who need them the most within these communities. But civil society cannot do it alone. It is clear, it is hugely important that the state authorities come in with people on the ground to help and fight the coronavirus in these communities.